Following the same example, if you look at the and a mention was made about it, that people are able to raise some Ponzi schemes in the country, and it is a menace. It is a serious menace. And we had a situation where there was complete lack of clarity about which agency is going to look into these collective investment schemes, because they are not registered with any of the 5-6 possible agencies. So government has come out with an ordinance saying that there is now a legal presumption that if an amount is raised above rupees 100 crores, there is a legal presumption that it is a CIS. We have been able to pass orders against several entities. Not only that, we have been able to utilize the enhanced power given to us by the ordinance that we can now, and we, in one case we have also passed recovery orders, we have passed orders for attachment and things like that. But I would like you to go back and think that while these actions are there, enforcement actions will continue, enforcement actions will be there. But before enforcement actions, I would urge that there is a serious need to relook. My simple point is that last 5 years has proven to everybody in India and outside India that it is no longer a situation where it is business as usual. People are becoming more demanding, they are becoming more aware, and they have their requirements have to be taken into account. Chitra rightly made a mention about pension money. And the statistics is revealing why in a country of our size, no pension money is coming in the country. But if you go and talk to the trustees of EPFO, for example, and a mention was made about the CAGR of Sensex being 17% and all that, it makes eminent sense that workers' long-term retirement money should be in the equity market. But you go and talk to the trustees, they do not have faith in the market, period. There is a Government of India Ministry of Finance notification that 15% can be invested in the pension market. But in spite of that, we have not been able to generate that sort of a trust in the main managers and trustees of the pension funds in the country. So a lot of work has to be done towards this area. The last point I would like to make is that for an investor, whether he's a domestic or a foreign investor, besides the behavior of people who are intermediaries and regulated entities, there is also a serious need to work towards the corporate governance in the companies which are registered on the stock exchanges, listed on the stock exchanges. Some of the measures which we have taken in the recent past, for example, are measures with regard to the buyback regulations, because we found that there are a number of examples where the buyback regulations were being used just to support a particular price rather than for actually implementing the buyback. So we have brought in some considerations. We had several examples of the misuse of merger and amalgamation procedures, especially with regard to related party transactions. And I'm not blaming any one particular type of corporates. It has happened across the ownership structure of the corporates. So we have come out with certain requirements that before going to the High Court, they have to come to stock exchanges and SEBI. And my feeling is that that is now helping. We have also taken a number of measures with regard to disclosures, and we have come out with two circulars, 30th of September and 18th of November, particularly about the disclosure requirements. We had a requirement about the pledging of the shares by the promoters to be disclosed. They came out with some innovative exit option, that is NDU, non-disposal undertaking. So we have become wiser, and now we have also said that not only pledging but even NDUs have to be reported. But the most important thing is, if you go by the new company law, and we are also going to have our new corporate governance infrastructure and rules very soon in the future, we have to also educate people and be careful about the corporate governance norms which are being followed in the companies. And lastly, we have also, to all of us, everybody has to continue to work towards investor education. If we do some of these measures, and I always encourage and me or any other related representative body to have a dialogue. And any measure which we have taken has always been taken after extensive consultation. You will recall that the new financial code also provides that there has to be very serious and effective consultations. We believe in it. SEBI has been trying it for almost last 7-8 years. So I will welcome that any change or any suggestion you have as a group, as a representative body, please let us know. We'll consider that. But after considering that, if we impose something, it hurts if you people start thinking that we are becoming activists and we are trying to affect your business. I would like to put it that please think of it as a measure towards the long-term growth of your industry and long-term growth of the capital market.